Good morning. It's 5:46 right now, and last night I didn't sleep. I don't know, from quite some time I'm actually feeling the same thing. I'm not able to sleep at nights, like not me, even my parents are unable to sleep at nights. Our sleep schedules have like been all over the place. Rakshit is actually going to office, so I need to wake up at 8 o'clock for making breakfast and all. So we are actually sleeping at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock sometimes. I am actually sleeping at very odd hour, but I need to wake up at 8 o'clock because I need to make a breakfast and all. Yesterday night I couldn't sleep. I have tried all the things. I have meditated for some time. I have listened to songs for some time just to calm my nerves down. But no. I don't know what is happening inside my body. I couldn't sleep. And I was awake all night. And early in the morning, I'm actually very, very hungry. So I thought, let me make some breakfast little bit early so that I can give it for Rakshit also, and I can also have it. So I'm thinking to make pasta right now because I don't know, from yesterday I was craving for some pasta. So I'm making pasta right now. I have kept the water for boiling, and yeah, I'll take you through my day. This is a great beginning. Sleepless morning, or me, sleepless night.
Before anything else, let me show this view to you. It was amazing. I look up to all these sunset views and sunrise views. It might be a sleepless night, but it was almost equalized with this beautiful view in the morning especially. Here I'm chopping up a couple of vegetables to add to the pasta. I'm using onions and tomatoes, but you can use capsicum, couple of bell peppers or mushrooms or whatever you like to eat in the pasta. So I'm chopping up very like small diced pieces. I love to chop vegetables. I don't know, I feel it very satisfying. What do you think? Do you agree on my thinking and words? Let me know in the comment section below. Now I'm gonna start making the pasta. I'm gonna add a little bit of oil, butter, and then I'm gonna add the chopped onions and give it a good stir and let it cook for a couple of minutes. Now I'm gonna add the chopped tomatoes to the frying pan and I'm gonna saute it for a couple of minutes. And I added a little bit of salt so that it can completely cook, and now I'm gonna add ginger garlic paste. Now I'm gonna start adding all the sauces like vinegar and and Szechuan chutney. I added tomato ketchup, I added chili sauce and a little bit of chili powder. So this completes the flavoring and it really really tastes amazing. Just try it, adding a little bit of tomato ketchup and Szechuan chutney to the pasta. It really tastes amazing. Now I'm gonna add fresh milk to this. You can add cream also if you wish to. I'm adding milk here. I really want that runny and saucy texture, so I'm adding milk, and after that give it a good stir and let it cook for a couple of minutes till the milk gets a little bit thicker. Doesn't this look amazing? The sauce is yummy and mouth-watering, and obviously it was amazing to taste that sauce. Now I'm gonna add the cooked macaroni. I have already cooked this and kept it aside, so I'm gonna add that and give it a good mix till it is coated with the sauces which we have cooked. That is it. It really tastes amazing. If you like to add cheese, you can add it to the bowl which you serve. It really tastes amazing. Hola, this recipe is most requested. I have actually put up in a vlog. This is called upma roti, and so many of you asked for the recipe, so here it is. This upma is made last night, so it was leftover, so I'm preparing this today, and I've added loads and loads of vegetables to that. I love to add lots of spices like cumin powder and a little bit of pepper to give that boost of spices to the upma. Instead of having boring upma, you can do this to your upma. You'll definitely like it. If you like to watch a video on it, let me know in the comment section below. I'll definitely do it for you guys. Now I'm gonna take the upma and add rice flour to that. You can add a little bit at the beginning and then you can add on according to the texture of the upma. This should actually look like atta, but a little bit soft atta. You can see the texture on the screen, you will understand. Now I'm gonna take a pan and then put a little bit of oil and spread it across, and I'm gonna take a ball of the upma and with the rice flour which is added, and I'm gonna spread it on the tawa. You can do this method. This is actually the authentic method of doing this roti. Now to the atta, you can also add grated vegetables or paneer or something if you wish to add anything. I'm gonna switch on the gas and put the tawa on it and let it cook for a couple of minutes, and it should be like crunchy and it should have the golden spots all over it. Till that you have to cook. And now I'm gonna show the second method to you. You can spread the mixture on a parchment paper or butter paper, and you can do this method. This you can do it on a non-stick tawa also. The tawa will not get ruined that much. Yeah, this is the modern method of doing the roti. Once it's cooked, it should look like this. It should have spots all over it. That is the sign of a well-cooked roti. You can add a little bit of ghee to that, and I'm gonna add a little bit of achar, and you can enjoy your roti. Hey guys, so okay, we are just done with the upma roti, which I have actually showed it in my some vlog. If you haven't checked that vlog out, I'll link somewhere up here. Go check it out. I have made that upit roti on that day and showed it to you guys. You people have asked me about the recipe, how you can make it and how it is kids friendly, because the upma is like the upma which we make at home is like kids anti, so they don't like eating upma. So if you make a small rotis like this and just serve them with some ghee or ketchup according to their taste, they'll definitely like it, guys. I love this particular recipe. My mom used to make like from I don't know from my childhood, so we used to love this recipe.
and eat. We used to hate upma, and me and my brother like hate upma. Now I kind of eat it, vegetable upma, I kind of eat it. So my mom used to like do this jugad and make us eat upma with vegetables. With vegetables though, it tastes yummy like anything. The people who, the kids who are not very fond of vegetables, you can actually put some vegetables, grate it and put it in this, and you can cook it for a couple of minutes and done. It tastes amazing, guys. Look at the texture and look at it. It's so yummy. So I'm gonna have a bite right now. I have added the ghee and some achar. You can use any other achar, or if you prefer not to eat achar, then it is good as it is, because we have chilies and other salt, and I like to add a little bit of cumin powder also into the upma, and a little bit of pepper also, because it gives good flavor to the upma. We have all those spices in the upma and it is delicious with all those spices. So we need not use any other achar or anything. You can also have it with the curd, thick curd if you like that way, or ketchup or jam or whatever it might be. It really tastes amazing, guys. Amazing. Try it, guys. And if you have tried this recipe, do send me the pictures. I would really love to see all your pictures and everything. I'll be super duper happy to look at all those. And you can tag me on social media, also on Instagram. I'll put the handle right here. Please do tag me there. I really, really hope that you like this particular recipe.
After a good lunch, we all four went for a car ride. We didn't get down anywhere. We just went for a ride in the highway and we just came back. While coming back, we got to watch this very beautiful sunset view. Isn't it so pretty? The sky is so pretty right here. For the last recipe, I'm gonna add 2 spoons of ghee to the cooker and add spices to this. These are the spices which I'm gonna add to the cooker. And after this, you're gonna add cashew nuts also. It really brings out that good flavor and aroma. After this, add chopped up onions. I love to add more onions to this recipe. So add loads and loads of onions and saute for a couple of minutes. Then we are gonna add ginger garlic paste to this. I have taken 1 spoon, and after this you can add tomatoes to this. I have taken roughly 2 tomatoes and chopped up, and I'm gonna add salt also. Here I'm using rock salt, so I'll add the rock salt and let it cook completely. Veggies time. I've taken the aloo and made this huge cubes and added to the cooker, and then I'm gonna take carrot and chop up and add to the cooker as well and let it completely cook for a couple of minutes. To this I'm gonna add coriander powder, cumin powder, pepper, garam masala and chili powder, and saute it for a couple of minutes. Then I'm gonna take this curd, this is beated curd, and I'm gonna add it and stir it completely till it gets a boil. Then I'm gonna add the soya chunks and soaked basmati rice, pudina, coriander leaves, and put on the lid and let it sit. After 2 whistles and 10 minutes rest time, this is the outcome. It looks delicious and tastes 10 times better.
That's it for today's video. I really wish that you liked watching this video and learned a couple of recipes from it. And all the recipes which I've shown were very, very tasty and very easy on the hand. So you need not to have cooking skills to make these recipes. Any beginner can make these recipes. I really wish to see you making these recipes, and please do let me know if you are going to make these recipes, and please do like this video if you really liked it,
And take a moment to subscribe to my channel. It really means a lot to me. Please do subscribe. And yeah, very, very soon I'll see you with another fun video. Until then, take care and goodbye.